Yes. Good morning once again to all of you, class 4. This is our moral science period. In our last class, we read about how Hamid sacrifices his own wish for his granny. And we have completed this chapter, reading of this chapter. And we were doing the exercise work in our last class. So, yes, no, and matching we have completed, and I have given you homework to do it in your moral science copy. So today we'll discuss about answer question and make sentences with the given words. Make sentences is very easy. You have done this in chapter number 1 also, how to make the sentences. See, in here also it has been given. Make sentences with the given words. And I have described this to you very well, how to make sentences from the given words. First, you have to know the meaning of the word. What is the meaning of that given word? Then only you can make sentence, no? Okay. So, let's start today with make sentences with the given words. Number one, feast. What is the meaning of this word? Feast. You can understand this by reading the whole sentence also. What is the meaning of this word feast? Look here. A great feast is organized. It is your cousin's wedding party. A grand feast is organized. Feast means party. A great treat, a big party has been organized. So, what is the meaning of feast? Party, grand party. So, how you can make sentence by this word feast? Don't write meaning here. This I am just writing to explain you what is the meaning of this word. You directly write, yesterday we had a grand party, grand feast or feast at our home. Or yesterday night I have enjoyed superb feast. So this you can write yourself. You have to write sentences in your own words. Okay, don't copy it from somewhere. Use your own mind, own imagination and do this. See, second word is grab. You can easily get the meaning of the given word by reading the sentence also. See here. Grab the snacks or wait for someone to serve it. Grab means when you go for a party, you simply go inside and just have a jump on the snacks corner. No. Grab means to just have a jump on the snacks table and you just eat it like you have never eaten before. No. So what is the meaning of grab? To show a hurry action for eating something. Grab on something, jump on something. So, you can make sentence with the word grab. I have seen Ashok, he simply grab on the table which has been kept there on the party. So, you can make sentences of your own. Action. What is the meaning of action? Whatever we do is action. Whatever we react on something, that is our action towards something. So action, what we do, that is our action. We should have control in our body, in our action. So you can write any sentence with this word action. Emotion, what is our feeling, what is our emotions for something, that you have to write. Emotion, feeling, what we feel about something. Okay, make sentence. Rotate, move. To move, rotate. When something rotate on its own place, like planets, they rotate on their own fixed position, no? They rotate in a fixed position, fixed direction, that is rotate. Confusion. When there is a confusion, you really don't know what to do, what not to do. What is good for you, what is not good for you. So when in between two things you get confused, or when there are 5, 6, 7 dresses kept for you and your mom tell you to choose one, you get confused. that which one is the best, because we always want the best thing for ourselves. So you get confused. I hope now the meaning of these words are clear to you. So you have to make sentences with the given words. Now move to the answer question. Answer these questions. Define discipline. What is the meaning of discipline? Sister always tell you in school also, children staying disciplined. What is the meaning of discipline? Discipline not only means to say good morning, good afternoon. No, it is to give respect to all your elders, to give love to all your youngers, to be in proper uniform, to be in proper haircut, to have good etiquettes, to have good communication with your peers. Then only you can be in discipline, and you have to discipline within yourself also. When you wake up in the morning, when you take lunch, how you eat, what is your good habits, that all comes under your discipline. So define discipline. What is the meaning of the word discipline? So what is the meaning of discipline? Discipline is the art of living. So what is discipline? Discipline is the art of living. How we live our life. Discipline is the art of living. It is the control of a person over his or her behavior, actions and words. This is discipline. How we lead our life. How we talk with someone. Have we our control in our body? We have control in ourselves. That is discipline. What is our action? If someone have told you given wrong words, abused you, it is not correct that you also abuse the others. No, that is not good. You should make him understand that the other person had done something wrong. So discipline is that, to be in a good learning, to learn good manners. So what is the answer of question number one? Discipline is the art of living. It is the control of a person over his or her behavior, actions and words. This is discipline. Now move to the next question. Question number two. So as to be disciplined, how would you manage your daily activities? What should you do to manage yourselves, to manage your daily activities? What you can do? Yes, see. A disciplined person, this is answer of question number two. A disciplined person sets a timetable for all his daily activities and follows it. He has a fixed time for watching television, for playing games, for his studies, and for eating and sleeping. This is the way how we can lead a disciplined life in our daily life. I hope these two answers is clear to you. Question number one, what is discipline? This is the answer. Question number two, how we can adopt discipline in our daily life. We can set fixed time to see television, for playing, for studies and for eating and sleeping. Very good, children. Now come to the next question. Why did Hamid buy a pair of tongs? Why Hamid buy a pair of tongs? Tell me. Yes, Hamid bought pair of tongs for his granny. Surprised him. See, Hamid gave that man 5 rupees and bought the pair of tongs. For whom he have taken? He have taken this pair of tongs for his granny. Why? He always see that his granny's hands burn while making chapati for him. The tongs will save his granny hands from burning when she make roti chapati for Hamid or for herself. Understood? Okay, this answer I will give you in written form in PDF. Okay, you will get this in form of PDF in our assignment day. Okay, next question, last question. What lesson do you learn from the story Hamid's sacrifice? So what you learn, what is the moral of the story, what you learn from this? Have you learned anything? Yes. What we have learned? How to control our feeling, how to control ourselves, how to control our emotions, how to control, have control in ourselves. How Hamid controlled his feeling, and in spite of spending that 5 rupees in eating chaat jalebi, he had taken tongs for his granny. So this chapter make you learn the chapter of sacrifice, how you can do sacrifice for your own members of the family or your very good friend or anyone with whom you are very much connected. So this chapter give us lesson that we should live a disciplined life, we should have a control in our feeling, our emotion, our action. So what we have to do? Always think twice and then act with wisdom. Wisdom means to take a correct judgment. Before doing anything, we should think twice that what is going to be the result, consequence, what is going to be the consequence of that one, what will be the result. Okay, so always doing something, think twice. This is the moral of this story. Self-control. This story tells us how to have self-control in ourselves. Self-control helps a man to succeed in life. If you have control in yourselves, you will definitely get success in your life. So question number 4 is also clear. Question number 3 and 4, or all of these 1 to 4, I will send the PDF on assignment day in the to your site. Okay, so you have to make sentences in your own words and this answer question. Now our chapter number 2 is also complete. This is really a very nice chapter. Children, you should also learn how to take care of your mother, how to take care of your father, how to take care of your elder sister, your younger brother. So you should love each and everyone and respect your parents, your teachers, everybody. Okay children, we have completed our chapter number 2 also. Now see you in our next class. Till then, take care of yourself, stay home and stay safe. Bye bye.